Some local parents say it's a change that's long overdue.
A new bill in the state legislature would require that private insurance companies in the state health plan cover the diagnosis and treatment of autism.
News 13's John Lee joins us now. John, you spoke to a dad who's very passionate about this proposal.
That bill cleared the House last night and is now in the hands of the state Senate. An Arden man says North Carolina has lagged behind on this issue far too long.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
At Koons Intermediate, Nicholas Hemachandra represents the 1 in 50 kids in America with autism.
Can you see a pattern here?
But in the eyes of his dad, Ray, Nicholas is 1 in a million.
Nicholas is 12 years old. He was diagnosed with autism when he was 4. He had less physical contact. He was verbally delayed. He's an amazing boy.
Ray, now an advocate for parents like him.
Well, when you know there's something out there that can make a difference for your child and you can't afford it, I think you feel as a parent, this is what I experienced, that you're failing your child.
He says House Bill 498 would bring help and hope. Right now, North Carolina, among only 18 states that do not require employer-based insurance plans to cover children with autism.
North Carolina used to be a leader in autism coverage for good reasons. It's been tough budgetarily all across the country and in North Carolina. This bill, as I understand it, covers applied behavior analysis, which is the main therapy used to get greatest effect at younger ages, as well as speech therapy, occupational therapy, and physical therapy, which are very important therapies ongoingly throughout a child's life.
Very good observation.
That's up to $36,000 a year in crucial care that many just do without. 2 years ago, Nicholas received a Medicaid exemption that gave his family some relief.
Prior to that, he did not have that coverage. So when applied behavioral analysis, when that intervention would have been most effective, we weren't able to afford it.
All right, Heather, what do you think?
And for dads like Ray, kids like Nicholas are the driving force behind the push for change.
It's a compassionate bill that his families truly suffering would get help.
And Ray says this bill recognizes that huge shift in our autistic population, but some argue it would only drive up the cost of doing business in North Carolina.